Bah.
What's going on, everyone? Welcome to NAW every Thursday here on twitch.tv/doseofnerdak. And then we're live, episode 954. And we're going to kick things off tonight with our first championship match. I believe we have 8 titles on the line tonight, as well as an election process that we promise is not corrupt. Although I'm not buying it because of Thorn. But hey, it is what it is. We'll get your predictions in. Opening contest here, Selene defending their title against Lana. GM election night. Opening contest. Get your predictions in.
The following contest is a falls.
First match. Yeah, what's up? Chris, Ramon, Emma, Chris again, Icon, John. How's everybody doing? You guys good? And shout out to J to the O to the S to the H. We can't say his name. Damn good arena. Damn good arena. I'm liking what I see here. Leaves are still falling in fall here. What's up, Caliber? And of course, that pumpkin. Somebody needs to dispose of the jack-o'-lantern down there. I don't know if you guys have seen that throughout the season, but it's starting to rot. It's not looking good. Thor says, I'm here and will still be your GM at the end. We will find out later tonight, of course. We will be voting. And I'm being told that you're going to be able to add to votes by spending your cred, so that's going to be interesting. Replace it with a turkey. We may have to, because that jack-o'-lantern is starting to rot there. You guys see it? It's not looking good. It's tired as hell. I feel that. This weekend I plan to hopefully catch up on some sleep, but eh, we'll see. Sleep is something I don't see a lot of. That's all right. If you haven't yet, as always, share us out. Let people know we're live and we exist. We can't exist if not for you. And what is up, Ty? Sleep is for the week. The weekend. Maybe. Tomorrow, Theo starts karate. So he's going to come back with a new character, the Karate Kid. You guys, y'all better watch out for that. It's gonna get real in here. Ketchup and turkey. That's so weird. So weird. That's alright. Everybody likes different toppings. Theo puts barbecue on literally everything. And hey, if you want to hate on something, hate on me for this. You ready? I put ketchup on my macaroni and cheese. Who does that? Who does not? That is bomb. Okay, we're on the same page. He said, oh, blah. No, not dude. Ketchup always goes on mac and cheese. What about pineapple on pizza? Always. You're judging me? That happens. Seems to be the week for judgment. What do we do? Selene here. She just floated for a second there. Selene, your DNA champion. If it's a repeat? Dude, they ain't leftovers when there's macaroni and cheese. Shepherd pie, man, that sounds good. I haven't had that in a minute. Turkey and ketchup. I tried it. I don't think it's my go-to. And yes, always pineapple. You mean the pizza goes on the pineapple, right?
From Ann Arbor, Michigan, the boss, Lady Andrea!
DC, where are you from?
And her opponent, from Santiago, Chile, the international. National Heavyweight Champion, Selene.
He said Ohio. See, that makes so much sense. Speaking of Shepard, isn't today 11-7? Doesn't it have significance with Mass Effect? Anybody a Mass Effect fan? Isn't there significance between that date and Mass Effect? I could be wrong. That's what it's all about. Right there, though, the DNA Championship in the women's division. And again, as you guys find your seats, welcome to GM Election Night, episode 954, opening contest here, title match. We got 9 matches tonight, and I believe 8 of those 9 are championship matches. We should have called this Night of Champions. We're going to have some fun tonight, though. Selene starting out with a dropkick. And oh my god, almost a squash to start things off in here. Mass Effect is going to show him some time. Man, what's not getting, I'll show that to the video game. I gotta ask you guys a question, okay? How many of you guys played the Borderlands video games? How many are fans? And yeah, Mass Effect's good. Except for drama, that one's kind of broken. Nice takedown here, into the cover. Absolutely loving this arena, though. Again, shout out. Amazing arena. This turned out so good. Bravo. Bravo. He loved 3, Borderlands 3. Time for the mercs to take over. Did anybody else like Borderlands? Did anybody see the movie? You're welcome, OG. You're welcome. And the movie looks interesting. So the movie got a lot of hate. Okay. I watched it the other day. And it was really actually not bad. Choke being applied here at ringside. Will Lana pass out? Will we retain? Lana just passed out. Our first title match is a retain here. That's a statement made right there, taking out one of the most decorated, if not the most decorated talent in history of NAW. Lana, of course, falling victim here to Selene. DNA champion retains her belt in the opening contest here tonight. But yeah, if you get a chance, check out the Borderlands movie. It's worth a watch. It was a lot better than a lot of people said. It flopped in theaters, and they considered it a commercial failure because it didn't make much money. But it was good. It was decent, if not good. I don't know about great, but it was good. The Twisters movie, on the other hand, that was not so good. But that's my opinion. Ladies and gentlemen, if you watched Halloween last week, not the movie, the Halloween stream, I want to give a shout out to everybody that came out during the day. Half of Halloween was a success, really. We had really good engagement and viewership, thank you. We had a point during the show, though, where the stream crashed because we had a power hiccup. And, of course, it was right at the beginning during the entrances of the finals of the King of the Ring tournament. So we did not get to determine a victor during that stream. Well, we're going to determine one right now. Because Wiggie will be defending against Evan Rock, who made it to the finals of that tournament. So you have to, pardon me while I enter the names here. Well, I guess I could do the day entrances. You'll have to pick who's going to walk out with the King of the Ring. I was so annoyed that it crashed right at the end of that damn tournament. It could have crashed any other time, but it didn't. So I didn't want to rob you guys of the match, because both these competitors deserve this opportunity here to compete. And the benefit of both the talents is that they're coming in fully rested now. This puts the King at actually a disadvantage, as Evan Rock was going in with a 3-streak win. And he wasn't going to be 100% because he was in the tournament, whereas the champion just sat by to wait. So Evan Rock absolutely has a major opportunity here. And we're going to see that next. Get your predictions in, if you have not as of yet. We got promos that we're going to be airing here in a little bit. I'm just pushing it back and match. I want to make sure everyone piles in, so that way people can see who they're going to be voting for or who is making their pitch for the next GM. It ran, yeah, when everything came back up, it was all muted and like weird default settings were on. I don't understand what happened with that. So that was kind of odd. The true GM is Liam. We'll find out. One half of the tag champs and King of the Ring here. Dual champion Wiggie, one of our rookie talents from this summer, making their presence known as a dual champion here. They're still really green, in my opinion. So this is interesting. You got to vote for the fellow Scott. Everybody very open with their voting. I find that surprising. Is it going to be a landslide victory, though? That's the question. And with the ability to buy more votes, is that going to shake things up? After half of Halloween, how many people actually have any cred to spend left? Because you could technically manipulate the results here by spending your cred. You're not a shy girl. Me either. It's true. No comment. Icon got the money. If you guys need some handouts, Icon's the man. King of the Ring, our second match, our second championship match here tonight.
Weighing in at 239 pounds, the X Factor, Evan Rock. And his opponent from your darkest fears. Weighing in at 240 pounds, the Heritage Champion and one half of the World Tag Team Champions, the Rejected.
Well, let's see if it's been a fluke for their success or if they'll continue staying on top of the division here. We've had one title match, one champion retain. We've seen events where multiple championship matches, nobody retains, and then we've seen obviously mixed bags of results. Will everyone retain tonight? That's a good question. So champion Wiggie here against the challenger Evan Rock, and here we go. And a famouser from Evan Rock to start things off. He goes quickly into the cover now. Leg is hooked. And a two count, but a kick out here. Thorn says, honestly, it'll be a load off me if someone else wins, then they can deal with the Karens. So that's the thing. The campaign trail started off hot, then it kind of fizzled out down to really... just a couple candidates running tonight. We don't have a lot of promos that were submitted to run. So we've narrowed the field down to seemingly, I think, two? Sling blade takedown here. So it's kind of, oh my God, he just broke his spine on that trash can there. Did you see that? What the hell is that? So it's really boiled down to that. And it's also gonna be who the hell is going to show up to vote. You know, if views are low, people aren't here, they can't vote. So it could be whose support team showed up in numbers. So if a lot of people that were supporting one person here didn't show up tonight, that's bad news for their campaign, right? It's also being said, if you are newly elected general manager, that Thorn's term would come to a close at the end of the pay-per-view in December. So the final match, the closing moments of that pay-per-view are the last moments that general manager Thorn can make any decisions, make any signings, make any changes to anything. That is their last moment. The 1st of January, officially, we would welcome in then the next general manager. And then they would take control of office and basically how things are run around here. What's up, Satoru? So it'll be interesting. Pinfall attempt here from the King on the outside of Evan Rock. Is that Santa? Ain't Christmas time yet. No Santa. Speaking of, you gotta wonder, will Santa show up this year again? He's had quite the history with this roster every holiday season. Haley says, hopefully the roster is smart. And a pinfall attempt here. Imagine if you lose, what do you care what happens in NAW over the next 2 months? That's a good question. Will we have a peaceful transition from Thorn to, I guess we should just say it now, his opposition, Liam? You all know it. And what the hell will Thorn do if he's not reelected? So it's going to be interesting. These next 2 months, regardless of the outcome, are going to be interesting. It's been one hell of a toxic environment, in my opinion, with Thorn in office. I've vowed personally to rid us all of the darkness. Pinfall attempt here. King to retain, though. I personally made it my goal, my mission. And as of right now, for War Games and Survivor Series, I have no alliances. I've walked away and been betrayed from everyone that I've partnered with. So I honestly don't know who I can trust and what I should do. So the biggest question for me tonight, do I support Thorn in this election? No. But can I support Liam? He's had one hell of a rookie season, in my opinion. But he's also aligned himself with people like Christian. And a pinfall attempt here, two count. So it's a question of, sure, I could support Liam, but I don't know that if I could support Christian. Line himself with the best. See, it's that arrogance I can't stand. I would never be like that. Better keep my word tonight. See, but my word means what to you? I said the trade-off was, yeah, put me in the elimination chamber. I'll vote for you, Thorn. But what if I lied? Because guess what? It didn't get me, Thorn. It didn't get me the title back. So yet again, you screwed me over. You knew I wasn't going to win that match. You knew I have a horrible track record in the elimination chamber. Yeah, I wanted in it. But I also wanted other advantages that you didn't give me. And a low blow here. The referee allows it. And ladies and gentlemen, we have a new King of the Ring.
Your winner and new Heritage Champion, the X Factor, Evan Rock.
Mystery says, I know we've had a history. Focus on a moment, he says here. The moment you walked into NAW, I welcomed you to your first match in Texas. You know, I think about a lot of days in the past, to be honest with you. I think about a lot of moments. People I've backed, people I've feuded with. Do I trust the blueprint? That's a good question. You gotta wonder who he would align himself with. That's the bigger question. Who does Porter side with in all this chaos and division? I don't know if he'd even tell us, to be honest with you. But congratulations to Evan Rock. We know who Invictus stands with. Do we know? Seth is the house show. Me versus Seth. I got two freaking casket matches coming up, and I hate it. Marc Caliber, rather. against me. Why the obsession with me, Mr. Caliber? In general, why are people so obsessed with me? You know, it's not just Marc Caliber watching from the shadows, commenting on so many things, and just obsessing over me. I have people from indie leagues around the world in these sweaty, stinky gymnasiums. Somewhere in Texas, I think it's Dallas. Just a stinky, stinky gym. Some unwashed dude obsessing over me too. I don't understand it. But Marc here continued to watch and watch and watch and watch and troll me. But why? But why? I have nothing you want. So leave me alone, Marc. Let's end this tonight, Marc, you and I, inside this casket match. And if I win, Marc Caliber, just leave me alone. Okay? You just made the list, Troy. Thank you for the sub. Thank you, sir. I appreciate that. Times 27. For my long-term subscribers to this channel, I want to take a moment out of being an asshole in character and say thank you for the continued support here. It genuinely means a lot to me. I sacrifice a lot of time and effort and energy and give a lot of myself to you guys each and every week. I know a lot of you know me for this character. You may not know me personally. You may have gotten to know me. But I do want to say, honestly, thank you. We approached this milestone, episode 1000, and I don't know what the future holds. I'm in a lot of places mentally, and I got to be honest about that. So, but as I figure things out, of course, I'll always continue to be transparent about things. But for my long-term, even new-term subscribers, people that spend your money, whether it's through Amazon Prime, which you get through another paid service, you get that free. But still, you're picking this channel to use that credit on. Thank you. For people that donate bits, thank you. Hell, you're donating your time, guys. You're taking effort to chat up that chat down below me here. Honestly, you don't have to choose this channel. You can choose any other one, but you pick this one. You pick this place to hang out. You pick this place to make friends and be creative. Thanks. Really, thanks. We'll talk more in the coming months. Okay, we will. But for now, Marc Caliber, business. Business is at hand. 100 bit donation, hip hip. Hooray, thank you for that, Chris. Business is at hand. God damn it.
This message was brought to you by the Syndicate.
NAW is at a crossroads. A battle between order and chaos, loyalty and betrayal. I'm the darkness that keeps NAW in check. Under my rule, NAW has flourished, rising to new heights, delivering the most brutal, electrifying matches week after week. This ring, this organization, it's my empire, and no one else can protect it like I can. But there are those who want to see NAW's foundation crumble to benefit themselves.
The Syndicate backs Thorn because he's not just any leader. He is a relentless force that has brought NAW to greatness. The Syndicate understands power, and Thorn has proven it. Time and time again.
So I'm calling on each one of you, every fan, every loyal member of the NAW universe, to make your voices heard. You know what I bring to the ring? I promise that NAW will remain fierce, untouchable, and true to the fight.
Stand with us! Stand with the darkness! Because with Thorn as your GM, the NAW will never fall! Cast your vote! Keep the NAW in the hands of a true champion!
This message was brought to you by the Syndicate.
So a re-elected Thorn with Satoru, the Syndicate, Matsuda, Akira, and his side. Could you imagine a superpowered darkness syndicate operation? Is that what you're voting for tonight? Or are you voting for just a single man, Liam? No cabinet, no alliances. Hell, I don't even know if the Mercs truly endorse him. They say they do, but I think they're using him. I don't know. You'll have to figure that out with your votes tonight. Cast your vote, of course. That's coming up later. And Jake Hardy, out of character here again, man. You're not welcome here. I want to address that real quick, too. For anyone that's had any issues with me on social media and the way I've said things or opinions or stances on topics, I'm not booting anyone out of this company and this place based on your beliefs. That includes religious, political, you name it. As long as you are not trolling any of the other roster members and harassing them and imposing your beliefs and arguments onto them in a terrible harassment way. There are others that, yes, I have removed and will not give chances to because they have done just that. So, Jacardi, if you want to stay, technically you hadn't violated any of our policies, and we're not going to all agree on everything. And again, I've said that. It's okay. I'm not kicking anyone out. Just don't be assholes to people. Don't be in people's DMs. Agree, you know, disagree, it happens. But sometimes oversharing information in your opinions, sometimes it's just best to stay in your lanes too. I gotta be honest about that. Am I loud and vocal about my opinions? Fuck yeah, I am. I'm passionate. But if you know you're coming into somebody else's turf that has a vastly different opinion, you're gonna get some feedback on that, and sometimes it's not so kind. And when it comes to me, I'm going to defend the things I care about and the people I care about. So I feel like I had to address that real quick to make sure you guys really get what I stand on. So respect. If you want to be here, be here. Just don't be assholes. Please. Let's have some fun. We're here for fucking wrestling. So coming up next, we have a casket match.
From Toronto, Ontario, Canada, weighing in at 232 pounds.
I love that DC, like, anytime he gets uncomfortable about anything, he goes to the cheese remark. DC, you don't like confrontation. He's very timid when it comes to that stuff. I gotta instill a little bit more confidence into you, sir. Did I see what? About buttholes? I don't want anything near my butthole. No offense. That's just not my thing. I'm okay with it for others, but my butthole's for pooping. And that's not a judgment on anybody. I like it. Many other things, and it doesn't matter gender. I just don't like buttholes in general. It has nothing to do with gender or orientation, so don't get it twisted on that statement. I just don't like buttholes. I just gotta make that clear. I enjoy many other orifices. Thank you, sister. People pleaser? You know, it's okay to be a people pleaser, but you're not going to make everybody happy. It's not possible. I told you that a long time ago when coming into this place. It's not possible. And apparently I still have the fucking title. This game is glitched the fuck out. I am not the champion, but I'll take it. You know, if anything, I'm the fucking people's champion, the final boss. Who it is. And thank you, iRob, 56 months. I'll be adding to the list too for subscribers of things you'll get to pick to add to the spin wheel again this month, so be on the lookout for that. We'll do that leading up to the Go Home show again, just like we did in October. I think that was a great success, and we're gonna have fun. Am I gonna whisper it? No. Again, booties, no. Wieners, sure. Boobs, vagina. Can I say any of these things? but not booty butts. Not the whole. Like, I don't know. Some people are really into it, and I'm okay with that. Again, there's no judgment on that. That's not how I roll. I'm just not into it. Money in the Bank has been doing it a lot. Hold on. Money in the Bank has been doing AI cash-ins? This has been broken since we launched the game. I haven't seen it do it once. John asked a really good question. Am I going to be using the final boss theme in 25? If it's in the game, hell yeah. DC starting to come to terms with the fact you need to focus on yourself more. Everyone should. I give a lot of my time to each and every one of you, and I can tell you this, I don't give myself a lot of time. I need to focus on myself more. It's a fact. Touch tips? Here, touch that. Touch it. Maybe Thorn might make stuff half price all the time. He very well could. It seems like bribery. At least on your game. I might have to pick your brain on the settings then that you're using, Marc Caliber. In universe mode, I'm curious what's different. What's up, Lana? First, what are you playing? I saw the Xbox fire up. The boop! We have not booped in a long time. Boop it.
The following contest.
See, these are lost things, guys.
Casket match. There are no pinfalls, submissions, disqualifications, or countouts. The only way to win is for a superstar.
See, Caliber, you're creepy. I don't like that. He begged you to play Minecraft.
The remaining superstar will be declared the winner.
He got you.
Now, let the match.
Look at this, dude. This arena is so sick. J to the O to the S to the H, because we can't save Josh. Back rubs, brah. You did it. No excuse this time. You got it, Caliber. Bring your beast. Let's play. Nice reversal here. God damn. I love that you guys are contributing by making arenas with that prize. It was such a good idea. I know Chad has made some really good ones too that we've tried to find ways to incorporate, hence the Japan stuff. 5-bit donation, hip hip. All right, thank you for that, sir. Springboard flippy flopper. He landed it. That's what it's technically called, if anybody's curious. I named that move myself. I'm very creative. Into the buckle, but a nice reversal there from Grav. This is what it's all about. Thank you, Chris. It is a nice name. I worked hard on it. I lost a couple nights of sleep trying to find the right way to describe it. NAW London? That'd be cool. McDonald's has Mario Kart Happy Meal toys. DC. All right, DC. I gotta ask you a question, Mr. DC. Do you get access to the toys? Like, can you set some aside? Can you get the set of them and mail them to me? I will pay you. He said, I will spend money on that. Burger King and a purple Whopper? That sounds gross. You can buy them? You can't just have them? What a cheap company. Face crusher here from Marc Caliber on the outside. Nasty chop. DC, we'll talk on the side. I want those toys. If you know anything about me, I'm a huge Mario Kart fan. So, this is a problem. Speaking of, for our Christmas episode, we are playing Mayo Kart for Christmas, by the way. That's what's going down this year. So we're debating on which one to play, whether it be the Nintendo 64 online or the Mario Kart 8 on the Switch. We played classic games last year. I think we might do modern. We kind of always play classic games. So, I don't know. How many people have Mario Kart 8 on the Switch, though? That's the biggest question. Because we'd want to play with people. You got an 8? Okay, there's one. And our last encounter, you beat me. I did beat you by countout, Caliber. You are the timekeeper. And I'm just a Louisville slugger here. The beans.
What?
Now, we're doing mayonnaise this year, guys. Mayo. Mayo cart. Mario cart. Mayo cart. I can't say it. I-Rob, buy a switch. Face crusher again here by Caliber. You explain on the sign? Okay. Yeah, we'll talk. I want toys. Oh my god, he's closing the casket! Mario. Yeah. Send you money? No. I don't have any to send. Mario Mayo Kart. Mario Kart. How many of you guys in chat want to see DC eat spoonfuls of mayonnaise? Famous are on the outside. Chris wants to see it. You got big bills, oh man. You do not? I-Rob does not. I got sis no. Thorn, you have got to be kidding me. The most devastating news. Time out right now, everybody. Ray Gunn has retired from competitive breakdancing. This is tragic news. What are we going to do in the breakdancing world now? There is no one good left. No one. Huge jar of Miracle Whip. That's technically not mayo, though. With hot sauce. Ugh. Dumped into the casket here is Marc Caliber from Grav. Grav gonna try to shut the lid. Can he do it though? Marc Caliber struggling. And Marc Caliber reverses. He's back in the ring here. Alright, I gotta ask the follow-up question now. Who wants to see me eat spoonfuls of mayo? Who will do the T-Rex? I don't know. You don't have to prick up? He's gonna prick up. He's gonna pick up rather. Pick up breakdancing. Snails. What you know about snails? Oh boy, here we go. A destroyer on the outside. What's up, Seth? Hey, yo. Hey, yo. Hey, yo, how you doing? It's me, Seth. Freaking Seth. The full diaper. What? Do you have to eat the whole spoonful at once? Yeah. It's going to be multiple spoonfuls throughout the stream. We're gonna be doing it where every so many like losses in a row, if you don't get first place, you have to do spoonfuls. And that gonna be fun. Grav dumped into the casket. Marc Caliber trying to shut it here on Grav. And Grav gets out of it. Yo, 25 months on a 3-month streak there, Connor. Thank you for the sub. How does it feel?
How does it feel, baby?
Excuse me, DC? If you say that really fast, I don't think you know what you're saying. DC, that should be the name of the podcast. That's the name right there. I know you know what you're saying. That's the name of the podcast, though. You can't do anything else now. Thirty-man rumble every time. It's hilarious. Oh no! They can't operate the TV. That's not good. Maybe you'll do two different ones. I mean, that's the name, though, dude. That's the name. Did you ask everybody already how many people play Magic? I feel like you did. I don't remember how many people responded. Yeah. Brainbuster suplex that. Do you guys want a podcast from DC? You guys always tuned in a lot when he did his talking things, you know, the watch-alongs. sleeper being applied here, but the point is you got to get him over to the casket to win. 12, huh? That's quite the number there. You students still kind of see. There are some people, DC. I'm telling you, I know that one. So he's not for me. Jesus Christ. You're back. My back. My back. My back and my back. Your friend is watching your dogs for a week. That's right, you're traveling soon. How exciting. Saving eight. Is that how much it is to board a dog? Good lord. Podcast will be until the first of the year. The microscope. Jesus, that's not very nice. I know DC's short, but maybe he's, never mind. But here we go, action continues. Casket match, our third match tonight of our nine match card. 500 per dog, good lord. Grav stepping in the casket there, but Caliber fighting back. You're not traveling. I shut the casket. Undefeated still in casket matches. I thought it looked like he was kicking out of the casket, though. I don't understand. Oh, that's a cool shot there with the NAW and DNA. Ah, oh, I think I found my new logo. Hells yeah. Sorry, Marc Caliber. I gotta ask you, though, Marc Caliber. Can you leave me alone now, though? Obsessing over me. Appreciate all the attention though. I do kind of like the attention. It's a weird thing I enjoy. Is it weird? I don't know, maybe not. I'll take a win though. Yeah, I'll take a win. So this win kind of puts me back in, I think, motion already. Of course, I'll submit a promo because that's the rules here for Thorn. I'll submit a promo next week. Here's the thing. John. Mr. John Wigginton. Mr. NAW champion. Yeah, that fake belt I'm carrying around, the People's Championship belt. It's going to be mine again as the real one soon. With my win here tonight, I have really no reason not to chase after you in the title. Because, well... let's take a journey back to Acumania 6. I've made a checklist and I pretty much completed everything there was to complete with anybody that was involved or got in my way during that match. Except for one person. God rest their soul, Shane Crow. But the spirit and legacy of him lives on through you. So, I do think that he would want nothing more than you and I to have a battle in our near futures. To show the world how good you really are. Because he showed us all how good he really was. And he was. He stood tall the end of that night as our champion. A deserving one at that. But, John... are you really ready to carry this roster on your back just yet? You see, he was, and he did. But John, I'm going to put you to your tests and limits. We'll see what you got. We'll find a way. We'll find a way. And iRob says, I need to be saved still. You keep saying that, Mr. Adam. You keep saying that. And you're supposed to write a promo for me, aren't you? I don't see one yet. What am I supposed to say? Apparently I'm supposed to say stuff. I don't know. We'll see. But John, we're going to dance.
How's it going, all universe? Hope everybody had a great week. Had a good Halloween. Nice weekend. Tonight's going to be a great night. GM election night. Let's make it great. I'm not here tonight because, well... a week ago, I had a battle of my life in a six-man elimination chamber match. where I face four brutally tough guys and one Karen, which we all know is in the back right now, grinding and crying to the GM Thorn about losing the match, not being champion. Well, such you be you, my guy, because here is your new NAW champion, the Lone Wolf, John Wigginson. And I'm talking to you guys tonight because I'm going to show you that I'm not just here for a title. I'm here to make this show great. And speaking of great, the GM election. Who am I going to vote for? Could it be Thorn? Could it be Liam? Definitely ain't going to be Dallas. Heck, I might even vote for Santa Claus if he wants to run. Maybe I'll get put on a nice list and get that bicycle I wanted as a kid. But it doesn't really matter who the next GM is, whether it's still Thorn or if it's a new person. I'm still going to work my butt off for this company and to help make NAW the best show on every week. Why? Because this is where the big boys play. And this is where all the men and women come to become legends. And speaking of legends, y'all wondering why I kicked Liam off of Garmr last Wednesday in the Elimination Chamber. Well, not only did I want the championship title, I wanted to be the one to take the three biggest guys in that match out on my own. I already took Grav out, so that's why I kicked Liam off of Garmr. I wanted to take Liam out. I did. I wanted to pin the devil, and I did. And then I won the NAW title. I wanted to be the one to defeat the top tier in this company, and that was my goal, and I accomplished it. But yet, I am not done. I will want to do it again, and again, and again. I will not stop until the name Wiggington is etched in the history books of NAW. When the future wrestlers look up and see the list of greats, and at the top of it, it will be S and J Wiggington at the top of the greatest people in this company. So let that be known to whoever is my next opponents. Bring it on, because I'm ready to show why I am one of the best of the best. That's the bottom line, because the Lone Wolf said so. So if you don't mind, I'm going to sit here at home, kick back, drink a couple of cold ones, and watch NAW. And good luck to any of the GM candidates.
Well, there you have it, your NAW champion. Not here tonight. He's taking the night off to rest. I mean, he deserved it. He worked hard. The Elimination Chamber changes careers. It truly does. 100 bit donation. Hip hip. Hooray. Think of that, Chris. So, yeah, props to him. Waiting in the shadows, though, for him at the next contendership match is, of course, Ty, myself, Christian, and I-Rob competing against him in a five-man match. That'll determine his first potential opponent for that championship at Survivor Series. So that is coming up in the house show next week. So you're going to want to tune in for that. But, you know, again, props to John. Props. He deserves the spot. But he wants to cement a legacy. You gotta rack up some title defenses first and make sure you're not a transitional champion, my friend. We'll see what you got. Coming up next, though, the Tag Team Championship is on the line here. Velvet Envy against AOV. And yeah, Chris, I got that on the sheet, yeah, but we haven't announced that yet. Jeez, spoiler. I gotta stop giving you guys public access to up some upcoming stuff. No, you're good, I tease. But yeah, since Chris spoiled it, we have had word that Cody requested a meeting with Thorn. Hopefully it wasn't more than this request. I would hate to see Cody joining the Darkness and the Syndicate. That would be truly wild. But Cody had requested to cash in his money in the bank next week. And he will be getting his title match one-on-one against John next week. So that is happening. And of course, if you want to contend for the title, all you have to do is submit a promo saying literally anything like that, saying, hey, I want to put myself in the rankings, get me a match. Promo can be as short as 10, 15, 30 seconds, doesn't matter. Could be up to 3 minutes. Just don't go over that, possible. Challengers here, AOV championship match coming up next. The champions favored to win this one. We shall see though. If Violent by Nature continues their reign as the top tag team in all of wrestling today. I'd like to say that was myself and Garmr, but he betrayed me. I somewhat deserved it. And this is why I have a hard time aligning with anyone anymore, because no one can be trusted out there, to be honest with you. Everyone is searching for that way to the top, and they will climb up each other's backs just to get there. DTA, if you want something done, you do it yourself. Oh my god, White Chocolate, I keep forgetting you're back. Yeah, the return of White Chocolate coming soon. And please don't say that you're coming soon. I can only imagine the promos. You're right, I-Rob. I won't let you.
And is for the World Tag Team Championship! Introducing the challengers, Les Femmes.
You had an idea for Halloween I should have done? Well, that doesn't help me now. But what's your idea? And I'm always good for, should have dressed up as Gravities. Oh, you should have said something. That's a throwback. He was on the show before. You guys remember when he was a commentator? Yeah, it was vulgar. He had a potty mouth, that guy. Tag team titles, that's what it's all for. Why is the camera just focused like that? Focus on the titles. Weird. This game. Champions, ready, focused. And here we go. Always in the dark. What? Yeah, I think you said AOV once with a Sephora vignette. Maybe not. I don't know. Pinfall attempt here. I don't know. At least he said nope. I don't know, I'm trying, like, I'm scrambling to think of something. I'm sorry, I'm quiet. I'm like, what the hell does AOV stand for? You can see the gear wheels turning. A promo explaining them would be nice. Other than more jobbers. Yikes! Think the game glitched? You don't think Velvet's hair is green? Oh my god, you're not wrong! Oh, why is it like that? Attention off victory. It'll be explained soon. So, there were some that submitted updates that I didn't get to. The kids had dentist appointments tonight. And it, honestly, this has not been the best week for my attention in the game. So, I mean, if you submit an update, you still can. I'm going to get them when I can. I know I always say the hard deadline is the first, which it is. That doesn't mean I don't check throughout the month and then snag updates. So if you have one that's late, just submit it. I'll get to it. So. Auditors of Virility. What the fuck? So if you have one that needs to be updated, I probably didn't get to them all. Most notably, and J to the O to the S to the H. You can attest to this. The Community Creations was having problems across PC, PS5, and hold on, Jesus Christ. Acumen Creations. It took me quite some time to download this very arena and continue to fail out. I almost gave up on it, but I was determined because I saw the preview and I was like, we can't skip out on this arena. This arena is gold. So, author of Virginia? We're giving hints now. Backed into the buckle. So yeah. I don't know. Where was I going with that? Oh yeah, updates. Jesus. Train derailed. Submit your updates. I'll get it. Survivor Series is the end of this month. Pinfall attempt here. Breaking that up. Envy there. Velvet also with the green hair. I don't know why the green hair from both of them. Why is it glitched like that? It's really weird. Candlestick broken in half. The author of violence. Yeah, this arena is available. And again, if you guys want to continue to add that as a spin wheel prize, I honestly think more people should add that as the prize, because I love seeing your guys' creations. It adds another depth of you guys making this show what it is. Six months, Johnny boy. Thank you for the sub. Your support again, as I said earlier, much appreciated. White chocolate's available. This guy, I'll tell you. Elbows to the midsection here, nice reversal. I gotta learn the names, just like I learned Invictus's names, which I never really did, let's be honest. The axe kick there. Which one's which? Julia is in the ring. Okay, tag made. Julia no longer legal. It's the problem with new teams. I don't memorize them yet. Kristen. Why weren't they JK then? Just kidding. They should have been just kidding, team. Just kidding. No? Just me? Nice setup here. Envy into the lock, though. In trouble here. Will she tap out? Championship on the line for this new tag team in the women's division. You got to start to wonder what they're all about, what their style is. We clearly have a powerhouse styling here from Kristen in the ring now. Do we care what their names are? I mean, you might have to care if they're going to be champions here in a moment. Lock up here into a takedown. Oh gosh, did you see the way her leg bent on that? That was awkward. Pinfall attempt after that awkward move there. I don't know why that did that. Pretty weird. This game, I'll tell you. And again, still to come tonight, we got our election. You'll be voting for either Thorn to stay in office or a new regime entering in of Liam and himself. The lone Liam. Although I fully assume his mercs will be part of his cabinet. But that's still yet to come tonight. I mean, like I said, Chris, I think Julia Childs, Kristen Stewart, that's not their names. Is it Julia? Julia? Pinfall attempt here. Oh my, she swinging and missing. She couldn't break up the pin. That was awkward. Velvet, the vixen of violence on the outside now, looking into the ring for one of Evan Rock's guitars. I didn't say the mercs aren't going anywhere, but I did say that you gotta wonder. It's gonna Kristen getting slammed here. Julia bringing the ladder in the ring. This match is gonna reach new heights. I just love it when I say that. I know you do. It's just so clever. Clever girl. Yeah, cover girl. Tag made now. Envy legal. Get to the midsection. Into a submission. Hold, everybody's favorite here. Will AOV tap out? Will the champions retain? We've seen one title stay, one title change hands, and that, of course, is the King of the Ring. If you missed that, Evan Rock is your new king. This is our third championship match on the card of eight tonight. Eight titles on the line tonight. Stacked show here. And once we get all our promos in, we will shift over to electing our general manager. Pinfall attempt here. And saved the day by green-haired Velvet. Don't know why that is. I didn't do it. Planted down. Into the cover now. Will this be enough? And a two count, shoulder up. The champion still alive in this match, trying to hold on. Lock up in the middle of the ring here. Into the buckle. Nice wear down tactic. Keep your opponent in your corner. They have to struggle to get all the way across the ring then to make a tag. And trying to get out of the ring, under the ring apron now, as you see Envy here. AOV, they're strategically going around. You saw one going back to the corner, the other going around the ring to cut them off here. No count outs, no disqualification in this match. Anything goes. We're letting it just play out. Stomp sign in hand here. But rolls out of the way. They lock up. And a reversal here as match continues. Championship night, we could call it, but it is GM election night. And it is down to Thorn and Liam to be elected. Obviously, if Thorn stays in office, there is no transition of power. And a nice stunner there from Envy. But if we do have a transition of power, that will happen on the 1st of January. Liam would take office then. It's always anything goes with Richard. Jesus Christ, man. Eat a Snickers. Hungry. Why wait? Choke out happening here in the corner. No rope break being called, even though they were caught in the rope during a hold. Into the cover now. Slow to position. Referee here counting. I don't think they'll make three here. I was going to say, you wasted too much time setting it up. However, they did get a 2.5 count. At this point, the gas tanks have to be nearing empty for both teams. Tag made now. Envy tagging in Velvet. Double team effort here off the ropes. And a double shoulder tackle takedown. Envy with a distraction there in the corner. Wouldn't it be a travesty in Lima's friends that were going to vote for them was detained by security? Could you imagine shenanigans like that with a moonsault that's missing here? Champions in trouble with that botch late in the match. Now a lock up in the middle of the ring. Again, cutting the ring in half favor in their corner, but a kick missing now. We're now working on the arm and the ropes there. It's on top of it going, but it's all right. Nice forearm strike. I mean, we kind of sometimes have security, but not really. It's true, you know. Thorn just kind of lets, whatever happened, happen. Ladder in hand now. And another cheap shot, but a reversal. Velvet in trouble here. Even crazier when the Scottish chick rams anyone getting in the way of Liam Brothers. Oh. You don't want a Scottish chick ramming you. Or do you? Maybe. That's not for me to decide. Because she would be doing the ramming. Anyway, y'all make this show super awkward. We don't need security. We might. Knee to the midsection. Envy going down now. Nice tilt-a-whirl. Neckbreaker there, begging for a tag. Envy, you better stay focused. A hot tag is made. You missed the opportunity for the advantage. Now you've gassed yourself out, running to the corner to get there. AOV with the advantage. Envy in trouble, face down. Into a cover here. Can Velva get there in time? And she does. What the hell? What is happening? Donnybrook? I said that I'm sure terribly wrong. I don't even know what that is. Pardon my ignorance to Irish and Scottish. I have not traveled the world. I want to, but I can't afford to. Short kings matter.
Do they?
That was Jade's finisher. I don't know why it does that. That's a weird one. Sledgehammer in hand now. Envy in trouble in the ring here. Step through. And that'll do it. Your tag team champion still. By submission. At this point, you gotta wonder who's gonna stop him. This is a dominant tag team. Absolutely dominant tag team. Coming up next, we have BBC. You guys excited for that? Who's excited for BBC? Nobody? Grav, Shane Maverick, Christian. He says submission only. Is it? Hell of a match. Hell of a match. But get your votes in. Now, goddamn, again?
This message was brought to you by the Syndicate.
Well, 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 looks like I'm back. And I'm still the one running the show here in Lama. But some of you fools, the fans, and even so-called talent in the back, actually thinks I'm not cut out to leave this place. You all really think NAW would be better off with someone else? Pathetic. Let me remind each and every one of you, and that includes you, Gravity, that without me, there is no NAW. I brought the fire, the passion, and the chaos that you all crave. Liam, I see you trying to hold on to that spotlight. But we both know you can hold on to that NAW or title without someone holding your hand. You needed all the help you could get. And guess what happened? The very next week, that belt slipped right out of your grasp. And you honestly believe you could be the face of this company as its GM? Everyone in that locker room, every single one of you back there, needs me to keep this place running. Because if it weren't for me, you'd all be lost in the dark. And Mr. Matsuda here, he's just the kind of partner who understands the vision, the power, and the brutal honesty it takes to rule NAW. This isn't a popularity contest. This is a kingdom, and I am its ruler. So go ahead, keep throwing your empty threats. Keep acting like you're something, but remember this. I am the only one keeping the NAW alive and breathing. And let's face it, Liam. You just wasn't good enough to hold the belt. And you're definitely not good enough to sit on the throne as GM. This company. company needs strength. It needs power. It needs darkness. And I am the darkness that keeps this machine alive. Remember this at the end of the night. You are a man who had to have help defending his title against gravity of all people. Or someone who has successfully led two other companies and is making NAW what it is today.
Come on. Are you guys buying all this? I guess we're gonna find out tonight, won't we? He said, now's the time to let my backbone bend. He said, wait till you see that third. How many promos y'all got coming up tonight? Jesus. So Shane Maverick here with an opportunity for the BBC. Our next championship match, we still have the tag team, Twitch, DNA, and NAW championship matches yet to come here tonight. And of course, the vote. And I love this entrance a lot. This man so full of himself, the smug Shane Maverick. It's true. The more we advertise, the more votes we get. I think there is a glitch in the community creations that you could get it, yeah. So I have a hacked character. Shame on me. They're gonna shut me down. They're gonna shut you down, son. We call a bum. How is it not hacked? It came from an event in my factions. So how is it not an option for everybody? You had to earn it or something? So, you have to... So here's the thing. If you earned it on your character, how do I have it in this game then? It's just tied to your character regardless of me unlocking it or not? That's confusing. So is it just now in the game then? It was a what now, Sato? So how would I use it? You just copy? Not that I want that, but I'm just curious. Yeah, you gotta copy the entrance. That's fair. Now, can you edit it or would you lose the stuff? I'm asking for anybody that wants this. You can't Right. You can edit everything else, you just can't change the music, right? You can edit the motion. Or you glooge the hack. Yeah, okay. You can edit everything else. Well, there you go, Chad. If you want that song, that is how. Your character download count just went up from whatever it is, a few more. Yuck. This guy.
And introducing the champion from Detroit, Michigan, weighing in at 240 pounds, the Million Dollar Internet Champion and the World Internet Champion.
He said, I'm up doing that now. So it wasn't locked for people who didn't play the event? I mean, that's fair. I don't really play this game. I just watch it. I'm sure it's fun, though. But again, ladies and gentlemen, GM election night has arrived finally. If you want, and you should, share us out, let people know we're live, we exist. The more people here, the more votes that you can submit for your next general manager. Of course, without your engagement, views, involvement, we don't have a show. 20,000 times, that's crazy. That's a lot. There's 20,000 IROBs and other shows out there. So Shane Maverick focused here for the BBC, myself included, coming off a win here tonight in the casket match. And then Christian, of course, the defending champion. Champion could lose this thing here without getting pinned or submitted. But they also could retain the title in the same fashion, quickly scrambling in for the cover. Christian breaking that one up. Most of your downloads come from Invictus. Honestly, I don't even check my stats. I can't imagine they're all that good. Nasty slap to Shane Maverick there. The one eye rob is too many. That's funny. Waist lock here in an almost a double team effort. Haley's your gold star. Ain't nobody want my character. My character's got a bad attitude. And I still have blood on me from Ollie. Should probably take a shower. Nice takedown here from Shane Maverick. 2,200? That's crazy. IROB, how'd you get 20,000 downloads? What hashtags did you use? Kendo stick in hand now. And again, assaulting Shane Maverick here. Not your call, mostly images. Okay, that makes sense. Nice sit up here, but a reversal by Shane Maverick. Christian with a slide tackle takedown. People hate Shade this year. I wonder why. Is he shady? I don't put that stuff on there for trying to get a bunch of downloads on it. I don't really care. People want to use my character, use it, but I don't know, I'm not as creative as you guys are, though. I just try to make me, but not me. That makes sense. Almost 10K overall. Damn. Only had 400 DC. Into the ropes here, Grav hanging up to dry. Shane Maverick stepping in now. Shane Maverick with a cover on Grav for the title. Champ could lose here without getting pinned. A And Christian back recovered. Fisherman brainbuster. Fisherman suplex. Grab with that patented crossbody. Coming up short, missing there. Nice takedown. Lock up in the middle of the ring. You downloaded a bunch to make your own universe. I used to do that. Like, before NAW, me and iRob used to, we did this for years before the show. It's a shame we didn't start the show sooner. But iRob and I have been creating characters, friends, people we know, and just random things. I mean, for help. 25 years, iRob? When did SmackDown on PS1 come out? If you guys want to look that up. Because him and I went to Toys R Us, and I've said this story a million times, but it's been a while, so some of you might not know it. Him and I went to Toys R Us, shared some of the chore money we had been saving, and we bought SmackDown for PS1 and shared custody of it, and each had our own memory cards and whatnot. And we would do just what we're doing here with this. That was the original NAW, you know, a quarter of a century ago or whatever, whenever that game came out. Been quite a long time. And that's what we did, though. And we would make up matches. I had books and stuff that I wrote, pads of paper of matches and storylines. We did have joint custody, and we shared it. That game is on the shelf. I still have it. It's a pride of my collection. It's good stuff. Me and your little brother Dark Stoney made 40. Cost for SmackDown vs. Raw. Damn. When the dinosaur, I ain't that old. Jesus. We're all a bunch of haters. He's tapping. Shane Maverick just tapped. You saw it. Grab with the kendo stick in hand. Shane Maverick. Take down a Christian here, setting up. Grab is just waiting there with the kendo stick. When's he going to pull the trigger, though? Nice trifecta there. Now Grav turning his attention, waiting for that opportunity to bop him in the head just once. Pinfall attempt on Maverick. Title on the line. Will Grav be BBC? Could you imagine Grav with a BBC? Think about it. Cross body. Let's go. 1, 2, 3. Grav wants the BBC. That's a come on. How'd he kick out? That's some nonsense. Nice takedown there. Let's go. Off the ropes. Big splash. Maverick's distracted. Pin him. There you go. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. No. Damn you, Shane Maverick. Oh, yeah. I see you. Oh, no. Okay. Choke slam. Side slam into the cover here. But Christian. Christian, where are you going? Your title. What the f- This man got out of the ring when he almost lost the title. Takedown here, Shane Maverick now. Setting up Christian strike. What the hell? He's just assaulting the back of his head. Grav now. Stealing Maverick, plants him down. Christian laid out. This is your opportunity. Let's go, me. Grav wants BBC. Give it to him. Oh, that kick, though. 1, 2, 3. Come on. You've got to be kidding me. Kendo stick now to Christian. Christian said, oh, Shane Maverick just got busted open. Where are you with the King of the Ring tournaments? Like, backlogged or we... All the upcoming stuff is on the sheet. I think we have another. We do. Our next tournament's in a couple weeks. It's a full one. We don't have another full one, though. We do have one full one. Porter, Icon, Ragnarok, me, Cody Shade, Jay Ty. And then only Liam is on deck. So that's right. Yo, Marc Caliber, joining Legends House. You love to see it. Wait, wasn't Marc Caliber? You're already in Legends House. There's four for Legends House. Mark Caliber, you were already in Legends House. You can't repeat Legends House yet, though. Yeah. He already joined before. So we're not having rejoins yet. I can refund you, or if you have an alternate character you want to submit for it. Famous or the Christian. Or I can refund you. Pinfall attempt, let's go, BBC. What? You're kidding me. What does it take to pin this man? Are you kidding me right now? And a submission locked in here on Grav. Oh my God. Now Maverick with the suplex setup. This match is absolutely wild. Grav now waiting. Maverick exhausting himself with the slams. They lock up here. Maverick getting the better of the exchange. Snake Eyes in the corner, but a kick tanked on that scissor. But Maverick wisely rolled out of the ring. And a chair shot delivered to the face of Christian. Down goes the champion. This has been one hell of a match here. All for the BBC. Off the ropes. Big slam, Christian into position. Grav looks like he has a kendo stick again. Delivery to the face, dropping Christian, missing that one. And he's gonna go for a pin. Maverick in the corner, exhausted. One, two. Oh my God. Come on. This is wild. Lock up air. Maverick now, knee strikes to the chest. Grav laid out. Christian now. Christian's got a submission locked in. Will Shane Maverick tap out? Don't tap out, you son of a bitch. Don't tap out. Don't tap, thank you. Grav and Christian now. Face first into the buckle. Grav with the sledgehammer, signature weapon for him. Turning his attention, sees an opportunity. Maverick laid out, pinfall attempt. Let's go! I'm looking forward to it, Chris. You can call me Mr. BBC now, Chris. That's my name. Thank you, John. I'll take that. Such a wonderful name. I do, Ira. I do. Look at this. Yes. That's fine. That's fine. Three mid-carders fighting over an imaginary belt? Jeez. Coming up next, in a singles match, the tag titles will be on the line here. Wiggie, with his tag partner as a manager, against Ty, with Icon as his manager. That's interesting. Mid-career son, right? He said, damn. So that's coming up next. Get your predictions in. Who is going to be champion?
It's finally time. It's time for a major power shift to happen within NAW as Thorn is booted off his seat of power and we welcome in a new prosperous era with yours truly leading the charge. Tonight marks an exciting new beginning for NAW as we completely tear down Thorn's architecture within NAW. We are going to strip down his foundations and implement a brand new design which will allow all of us to blossom. However, I realise that along my journey, my mission to secure a bright future for this company, that I've been missing one key component. I realized that if we are going to redesign this newly vacated plot, build it all back up again and finish our design for a brighter NAW, then we need a...
Haha, I know, a blueprint. And as I have been kicking back after wrapping up my own little journeys, mentoring the small but mighty J Prince, yours truly was approached by this fine lad with an opportunity I could not let roll past me. My good friend speaks of architecture, and me, well, I speak from experience. And I've been building since I kicked down those NAW doors, and I've grinded knuckle and bone to get to the top of the echelon here. Through that journey, I have seen vile and underhanded tactics used by management and those in the pockets of said management. I've seen loopholes and manipulation run rampant here for months. You know what I say? Let's burn it down. Let's rebuild. A foundation built on intention, principle, and honor. Let's restore us to a time when hard work and effort brought forth opportunity. A time when hands stayed clenched instead of laid open, given things undeserved. NAW is a place I have embraced, survived, grown, and chiseled myself into the man I am today. And stepping back to stand here with Liam and you all for the first time, I can proudly say we can do this together. We can build it together. We can plot the future together. And we can finish the dictatorship of Thorn together. Ha! Together, NAW, we have the blueprint to your future, and you, you know what to do.
Didn't have that on the bingo card today. Wow. Okay. Whew. Well, that adds an interesting twist to tonight's vote. Even his own alliance says we need to talk there. With Chris saying that, Icon shocked. What's he doing here? I'm intrigued. So the vote is coming soon here. We are nearly time for it. We wanted to make sure everybody got to air their promos. So it is approaching time soon. We're going to need you all to share out the stream. Let people know we're live and we exist. We want the most amount of opportunity for both candidates to get their votes. So candidates, this is going to be your time in the next little bit here to do your final push to share out for your supporters to show up and vote for you. White Chocolate's pants are off. What? Ramon, you can't believe you're saying it. I mean, I'm shocked. On both sides, to be honest with you, Thorn and Saturo, the Syndicate, and then you got the Mercs pulling in Porter. I'm just waiting for Mr. Bradley. Like, what else is gonna happen? Is he gonna be a member? Miss Ramon says that was the first thing out of that. New stuff about that you have genuinely believed. So you want to talk about interesting relationships. Icon's biggest fan, we found out, ended up being Ty. And I don't think Icon could have been more excited than he was here for this. Icon embracing the stalker that was Ty. And now they're best friends? Another thing that I didn't think I'd be saying here on commentary. But with NAW, it is a show that continues to be surprising each and every week with unexpected things. And in all honesty, you don't want to miss moments, because if you miss moments, you could have missed the whole dang story. And this is a place that offers story unlike any other one out there. Because I guess the other option is just watching somebody on their Xbox upload, and they're just screwing around with Michael Cole on commentary playing Universe Mode for you. And it's an alternative. But here we have it. Tag Team Championship on the line in a singles match. And IRL, whose fault is that? Yeah, I gotta ask you, whose fault is that? Imagine Ty win. Ty very well could win. He could become Tag Team Champions. You gotta wonder, with Ty winning this, he has the choice of whoever he wants to give the belt to. Icon technically out here supporting him. Could he give the belt to Icon? I mean, I think that's the obvious. But it'd be interesting if it was something outside the obvious. Iroh, the Dark Syndicate is your friend. Some mounted strikes here. Wiggie, of course, the defending champion of his team with Archangel. They were crowned the tag team champions. If you missed that event, they were crowned champions at our Halloween event, Devil's Night. In all honesty, that was a really good event. Go back in time, check that one out. It's in our archives, YouTube. And Wiggie naturally should be going for a tag here. This was an opportunity for a little rest. But again, non-tag rules in this tag team championship match. One of our few times that the titles have been on the line in a untraditional sense. And Ty here turning things around when he's trying to get shown the door. And Icon helping out here. Icon just dumped a guitar into the ring. No disqualification, no rules, anything goes. So it was okay for Icon to help out. Nice leg drop with some flair. You'd be okay to have the title if Ty gives it to you. There you go, Ty. You can give it to Icon. He'll let you give it to him. Snap spine there as Ty continues his efforts on the champion. Chris, ring veteran and legend of NAW, Mr. Ty himself. Been around a long, long time on this roster. One of our more tenured active talents here. Back body drop under the door there. Springboard off the bottom rope and misses. The waist lock now followed up again. Relentless in his efforts. Icon on the ropes now. Icon helping out, undoing the turnbuckle pad. Pinfall attempt though from Ty here. And a 2.5 count. Chris says Ty can hand it over to me and Liam. I don't think that's how that works, but maybe. The midsection up and bomb down. Ty with the cover there. Coach hitting, yeah, I heard you. And a nice right hand. What are you doing? What are you doing? Planted down. Wiggy now in control. Falls count anywhere. You heard the rules heading into this match. Anything goes. Pinfall attempt now. Whoa! 2.9. Ty almost pinned there as the champion. Continuing their assault. The knees to the midsection now. Sizing Ty up. Ty is in trouble. He's got the kick landed, double arm hook, and planted down. This could be the end here. Into the cover. Referee, 1, 2, and a 2 count. Crowd getting feisty on this one. And a drop kick there. And up. And removes all the clutter here. Will we actually get somebody through the table? We often see them set something up, but we don't often see them fully go through with it. Nice takedown. And a shot to the spine here. He's got him up. Turns him around into the driver now. And a lock up here on the outside. And laid him out. Icon excited there, applauding. One, two for the titles. And a two count, shoulder is up. And we continue on here. GM election night, election voting time is coming soon here. And the takedown. Now Wiggy turning things around. Our tag team championship match, our Twitch championship match coming up next. DNA, and then our main event, the NAW title on the line in the women's division. Shots to the side of the head here. And looking under the ring. He's all under there. He's got a light tube. It looks like it just busted over the head of Ty now. That light tube. Very effective. Lock up here. And dump back in the ring now is Ty. Wiggy to follow the referee in the ring. And Ty's hurting. You see him squirming around in the ring there. Ty out on his feet. Spring. Nope. Landed with that kick. I don't know if he got all of it though. Up top. Now what the hell you call that move? He's going for another. Other side of the ring. He landed him from both sides of the ring there into the cover. That's a photo finish in my opinion. And that'll do it. Still tag team champions. Ty falling victim. Wiggy retains.
Here is your winner. He retains.
These are scared guys. Coming up next, we got the Twitch Championship. Christian, Ty, Grav, and Rated. Satoru says, nice to see people earning their tag team titles, not asking for people to hand them over. Oh, damn. This guy. If it was 2-on-2, it would have been different, says Icon. Not a trend as of the last several months. And Thorn, I'm just holding this belt hostage. This is the people's belt. And my newly acquired BBC.
Representing the Dangerous Alliance from Ann Arbor, Michigan, weighing in at 234 pounds.
I've continued to check, by the way, on a character. I've continued to check. That title's not assigned to me. There's only one title, and it's not assigned to me. I've checked outside of universe mode, I've checked in universe mode. It doesn't matter. Can't remove it. I've lost matches for that belt too. Literally at the Halloween pay-per-view, it was a title match that I lost. And he still carries it around. I don't know why. It's the strangest glitch. Chris says, next week you're becoming the three-time BBC holder. You're going to hold three BBCs? At you. Next week should be really good. It's a good card. Ladies and gentlemen, it's been a hot minute. Don't let this man cook. You said make next week interesting? Yeah, we'll see. Let him cook! That's right. You let me have the fake title. Thanks, John. I appreciate that. I worked really hard for that fake title. Seth Turo said, who's this part-timer? What's he gonna cook? I don't know what you guys want. Something on the menu you want? So after this match, we will have you all call the masses in as we will begin the official process for voting for your next general manager. That again will begin after this match. Said submission only. I think that publicly putting yourself out there is the only way to show your support. Been discussing with Liam for over a month now about involvement. Oh, interesting. Look at this. Christian wants yet another submission match. He says, if I win, you'll never do it again. And if he wins, I trust him. Chat, what do you guys think about that? If I beat Christian in a submission match, he promises to never, ever do it again. But if he beats me, I have to trust him. I mean, on one hand, the roster's tired of your submissions. On the other hand, I don't have the numbers game for war games. I think that looks like a win-win for me, in all honesty. Saturo says, never trust a merc. Let me think on that one. That's not the worst deal that's been proposed to me.
From Detroit, Michigan, weighing in. 240 pounds, the world's internet champion, Christian the Enforcer Oxley.
As Christian here makes his way in, he lost, of course, BBC earlier tonight to me. Could you imagine me taking both of his belts tonight? It's very possible. However, again, in this match, the champion does not know, or I guess he does know, but he does not need to be pinned to lose his title. Haley says, I'm not a merc, I'm just done with narcissistic leaders. That's fair. Twitch Championship on the line here, of course. If you want to chase after that title, all you got to do is be the stream boss at the end of a show. Currently, our stream boss is the Lone Wolf, John. So if John maintains that status at the end of this show, he will enter the Twitch Championship next week. Liam and his so-called partners are snakes. The lion. Well, sometimes you have to take risks, I suppose. But here we go, Fatal 4-Way rules for the Twitch Championship. 100-bit donation, speaking on 100-bit donation there. Hip, hip. All right, thank you for that, sir. And apparently the stream boss did not update. Let's see why. There it goes. It updated. Yay! Fall car, everything I've done has been in the best interest of NAW. What happened to Atticus was just, how was that my fault? He attempted to submit a promo this week and was unable to due to his inability to still speak. How dare you? I guarantee that once he's able to, he'll have a few choice words for you. He's had quite the potty mouth lately. Frustration is an understatement. Merch don't do anything unless there's something in it for them. On the other hand, they're known not to keep their side of the deal either. Ty and Grav, no strangers to one another in the ring here. Ty going underneath. Chucks the chair. And down on top of his head, Ty to Grav on the outside here. That hip toss takedown from Christian here, rated on the entry ramp. Checking it, oh, he's cooking. Rated cooking out there. You see him, he's cooking. What is he cooking now? You gotta wonder. Big spear, nice takedown. And dump back in the ring here. And I gotta propose a question to both Liam and Thorn then. This is your last chance to bring everybody in to vote. This is your last chance too to prep your statements, whether you win or lose the election tonight. I'll hopefully expect statements from both of you. And Rady with a reversal here. So Jay, who's Jay? Baseless promises. First is at least I showed up. Well, damn. Pinfall attempt here. And Raider with a two count on me. I mean, Thorne's got a somewhat of a point. He showed up for his own election night. As did Satoru and the Syndicate. You gotta wonder, where is the opposition at? Lone Wolf hasn't decided yet. Yeah, there you go. Liam sent Porter in. I mean, Porter, you can make your pleas here to John. They're undecided, as can you, Syndicate and Thorn. It's in your best interest, says Satoru. Famous are rated. Down goes rated. He said, I've never left. Rated out on his feet here. Grav to the corner. What's he have in mind? And a takedown. Rated with a cover here. Rated could become Twitch champion. Ty, though, to break up the cover. And out of the ring goes Rated and Christian. Baseball bat in hand. Grav tried to go for a famous, but Ty blocked that. And baseball bat now bouncing off the head of Ty into the cover, rated on Grav. Christian, seeing this, breaks up the pin. Look at that. Thorn pleading now to John. He says, I know we've not seen eye to eye. We've met in the ring at least once. Christian now. Submission being applied to Rated. Will Rated tap out? Will this be it here? Rated fighting out of it. Strength prevails. The tie waiting with the baseball bat. Grav just doing poses at ringside here. What are you doing? He says, let them beg. The true answer is, do you want to be involved in people's pockets? Do you want your hard work to mean something at the end of the day? Why work hard when someone like Thorn can hand it over to somebody else? Damn. Oh, Christian! You sure you want to face me next week? Oh, man. We're just taking all the titles on election night, aren't we? Oh. It's a swinging fun. Guys, come on. You know you love to see this. Hell, I should have ran for general manager with my success rate tonight. Could you imagine? Man, this is so good. So good. Ladies and gentlemen, coming up next, the DNA Championship match. Let me get this going here. Icon, Liam, Garmr, Christian, Seth, Troy, myself again, and Thorn. So here's the thing, guys. I could win a third belt here. I could have three titles tonight. Wouldn't that be amazing? Get your predictions in, and then once the predictions wrap for this, I will begin voting for general manager. I don't want to run them at the same time. But once predictions submissions close, I will begin voting for general manager. So get your pushes out there, candidates. Have your people, your secondary accounts, whatever it takes. Get them all in here.
Look at that. Is an elimination match. And it's for the Classic Heavyweight Championship.
You said you hope for Liam or Troy to get the DNA title from you? You said if I win, we face twice. I think you might be right. Unless there's another stream boss. So if Chris holds stream boss to the end of the show tonight, and we don't do any other streams before next week, I'm proposing, Chris, that we do a 2-for-1 match. Two titles in one match. But make it 2 out of 3 falls. Submission only. Your potential next GM overslept on his job. That could sway votes here, Liam. It has been quite the evening. You're in time, though. We haven't voted yet. You got your last plea, your last opportunity to share us out. Right now, we got some terribly low numbers right now for views, so votes are going to be really low. I don't know where everyone is or if I've just pissed off everybody with my social media rants as of late, which is possible. Or if people are just gone. This is what you tell the He was partying a bit too early, says Thorn. Devil himself coming out of Devil's Night titleless. Unfortunately, he wanted that to be his moment, his night. It didn't go to fruition for we hoped. But a focused Devil here tonight on the DNA Championship. How many more matches? One. The main event is next after this one. That's it. A lot of fire and brimstone up from hell here on General Manager Election Night, episode 954. It means only 45-ish more episodes until the great milestone, episode 1000. I genuinely feel that's going to be a historic one. So again, get your people here, bring them all in, let people know. And submissions are closed on that, but it is time, ladies and gentlemen. You're gonna have the next 10 minutes. So everybody, share it out. Let people know it is officially now time to vote for General Manager. If Thorn stays in office, obviously there's no transition of power that needs to happen. He continues into another term. If Liam is elected your next general manager, what he gets is to take office January 1st, 2025. And Thorn will have to transition and end his reign as your GM at the end of the pay-per-view in December. That will be his last moments as your general manager. So think about everything that you know about these two candidates, all the promise, the people they're aligned with, the opportunities that you could have by supporting them over the other candidate. There is a lot online here. And who you are voting for. Saturo and the Syndicate, of course, aligning with Thorn in the Darkness. You have a mixed bag of new and old tendered talents in that group. You have Liam, one-time NAW champion, a new talent in his rookie year, nonetheless. And then, of course, Border, who has been here now 2 years in his second year of competing in NAW, so a little bit more tenured and experienced, but they are guards of the new era, if you will. Do they bring that fresh face and new focus to NAW? Or is the mix of new and old the best, if you will, the best for the future of NAW? So if any final last statements here from Liam, Thorn, from Border, from the Syndicate, this is your time to win over your voters. This is the time for election night. So plead your cases, chat. Plead to your community, to your people. These are your last chances. 10 minutes begins now. And there you have it. Voting has begun. 10 minutes are on the clock. Who will be our next general manager? And votes are starting to come in. seeing it start to climb up here. A neck and neck race as we begin our voting. And it's starting to spread out a little bit here. Said two men that want to help you do great things in NAW, says Liam. Are we buying views? Who bought views? Did we just jump up in views?
From Detroit, Michigan, weighing in at 240 pounds.
And we have a current tie. Now it's starting to shift a little bit. So in the lead was Liam. The Thorn has now pulled ahead by one vote in the current election for general manager. Time still left and it's ticking down here. And it is currently tied. But Liam has just pulled ahead by one vote now. Close election here. Liam is now ahead by two. Liam says, I don't think people realize the ramifications of Thorn staying in office.
From Westbrook, Maine, weighing in at 213 pounds, the Dark Horse.
This is an incredibly close election, everyone. It is currently 54%. 53% now for Liam. So just slightly over half. So sitting now, kind of idling at 53%. X Factor Evan with that resub. Thank you, sir. So it's kind of slowed down as far as votes coming in. 51% now for Liam. It is so neck and neck. Votes continue to trickle in and we have a tie again. 50-50 for Liam and Thorn. This is wild. We are currently sitting at a tie as our champion Icon making his way down for the DNA Championship match. Liam says his entire tenure has been miserable. Everyone knows this. Thorn pleading here. Thorn now pulling ahead by three. 53% favor Thorn now as your general manager to continue. This is wild. Thorn, of course, winning the general manager position over a year ago now. He's had a year in office. He won the position by competing on a 25-week competition. Keep that in mind. He won a 25-week competition. He focused working for you for 25 weeks, beating out Jackpot to become your general manager. Liam has worked his entire time here to better this place. So who do you want to favor? We're nearing halfway through voting here. And right now with 51%, 51% is Thorn. And we got our first elimination. And everybody wonders what happens in the situation of a tie. I've been told by the advisory board In the situation of a tie, a match will take place at a future date for the position. But again, that's only in the situation of a tie. And as of right now, in a lead with 53%, it has shifted now to favor Liam for your next general manager. So he's starting to pull ahead a little bit here. So time is ticking. Emma says, vote Liam, be smart. DNA Championship on the line, of course, happening behind us as we have active voting happening. Our main event coming up next. So once the election is done, we'll expect speeches from both candidates. So keep that in mind. Have something prepared. As the clock keeps ticking here, Liam still with a lead here, 52%. So it's begun slowing down. And Thorn says, under my GMship, I brought in a new generation of wrestlers and new champions. Icon, are you still in? I can't tell. And I'll be honest, I've been watching the votes here. Emma says, vote Liam, vote Liam, vote Liam. And we are so close here. It is a one vote difference between Liam and Thorn. And the clock is ticking, just over a couple minutes left on this election. This is making me nervous. Liam says, do we not know how dangerous this is? It is if any members of the syndicate get into power. That's just it, we don't know what the syndicate is capable of. Another tap out here. It looks like Liam was eliminated by the Thorn. Thorn just eliminated Liam out of this match. As action continues here, Thorn now just eliminating Christian. Garmr trying to take Grav out here. So we're down to Thorn, Garmr, and Grav. And a two count there. Three people left. DNA Championship on the line. Thorn could walk out of here, still your GM and DNA Champion, as the clock continues to tick down. Like it says, oh, I'm out. Damn. So Garmr jumped back in the ring by Grav here. Clock is ticking. We're closing out here. Opportunity to vote is slim. And Liam pulls ahead with moments left here. As we're watching this, this thing is just wild and neck and neck. You've got to be kidding me right now. It just tied and then pulled ahead again by Thorn. This is absolutely insane election. What's up, Garmr? Welcome in, just in time for you. And the clock is ticking down. We are almost to the end of this election here. If you haven't cast your vote yet, this is your last few moments. Can he get them? Vote for Liam, he says. Thorn with 54% right now. Famouser. Thorn eliminated by me. Thank you. To my duties as a member of the roster, you can't let Thorn win. My God, are you serious right now? Grav and Garmr, the final two here, and Thorn has just won the GM election. And Grav here trying to take Garmr out. DNA Championship on the line. And onto the apron here. We got hashtag rigged. There's going to be a possible insurrection happening against the darkness. This makes War Games even more important than it's ever been. Thorn spent 25 cred. Hold up, what? Why does it say that? Oh my God, it's true. He didn't spend any on Halloween. He set you all up to spend your cred. Are you serious right now? And Garmr reversing. I told you guys, you all should have voted. And Garmr knocking me out here. I told you all you should have voted for Liam because he set you up. Garmr getting his belt back by knocking me out. That's all right. I got two belts already. I didn't need a third one tonight. You can have it, Garmr. I'll let you. This is absolute wild breaking news here tonight. Thorn spent 25,000 cred to keep his spot as general manager, beating out Liam and to stay in office. Absolutely wild. Absolutely wild. I am shocked and just appalled here at this outcome. I don't even know what to say. Liam lost a cred. It was a rigged election, Liam. It was a setup from the get-go, and we all see right through it.
The following contest, Liam, is a fatal four-way extreme.
I gotta ask you a question, Liam.
And is for the Women's World Championship.
Garmr getting thirsty. Liam wants to know who I voted for. That's a great question. So, I gotta ask you a question first, Liam. Because I said I had a question for you first. Can you answer mine first? Marc Caliber. So what was the difference in the results? Like, how, if he bought 25, he would have lost had he not bought all those votes. Am I wrong?
And introducing the challenger from Ann Arbor, Michigan, the Boss Lady Andrea.
He said, you always hoard like 100,000 cred, your whole thing is taken down the dark. Literally the best time to do it. Jacardi voted for Thorn. See, look at the honesty here coming out of everybody and who they voted for. So, Liam, I'll tell you who I voted for, Liam, but you gotta answer my question I have for you. We both share one common thing here. We've both been screwed now by the darkness. Can I trust you to help me build a team for War Games to eradicate this roster of the darkness? While we might not be able to take out Thorn now as a leader, we can set in motion an insurrection to overthrow the darkness. Don't propose that, Garmr. You are in the match with the darkness. You can't trust Garmr. He's supporting them. See, I can't answer that question until you answer my question.
And introducing the challenger, representing Lipson Batons from Toronto, Ontario, Canada.
Jacardi says, Liam was the least of your worries. Now then, let the darkness overtake. My God. You have an opposition for me as well. Can you vote on this match? Is it not active? I didn't hit the button. Yes, you can. Please. He says that I'm out because you don't trust me. All right. You want to know what I did? I voted for you both. Because honestly, I don't know who I could trust either. And I made a promise that I would vote to Thorn. I was a man of my word. He put me in the Elimination Chamber. But I also wanted to see him gone. So I also voted for you, Liam. Are you happy with that answer? Is that what you were looking for? I took Christian's titles tonight. I sure did. It is funny. It was great. No. It's a common interest here. I don't fully support and endorse you, Liam. And I sure as hell can't back the darkness. This is merely a match of convenience for each other. That's all it is. It's a match that needs to happen. As you know as well as I do, how many other people can you trust out here to get the job done? Because they didn't show up tonight to keep you or put you in office. You don't have to answer tonight, Liam. You sure as hell don't have to answer tonight. I saw you got endorsement from Border. That's the thing. Can I trust that guy? Is he going to have your back in the War Games? I can't trust Christian. I took two of his titles tonight. And Troy. Troy's a lone wolf half the time. He's been in dominant factions before. But you never know what his next move is, and that's what makes him very unpredictable. But I can tell you this, I don't want Christian in the match with me. Because he's going to turn on me the first chance he gets. See, look at that. He wants to fight for submission and respect. Exactly, Garmr. That's the other point of it, too. As was Border. Could we be on the same page? Garmr and Sherwood. Invictus putting their hand in the fight. So, Liam, I'm proposing that here. Again, you don't have to answer. He says, I don't care for the righteous path anymore. I let myself go to the darkness. It's the only way of success. Now, look at that. Jacardi pledging his allegiance to the darkness. It sounds about right. See, JFA will step up. See, there are a lot of options I can choose. I extended my hand out of respect, Liam. We've been on interesting paths since your debut here. Again, you don't have to accept. Figured I would extend a hand. Women's championship on the line, though. Velvet, the defending champ. Hey, did you notice she has her normal hair color back? Did anybody notice that? John says they have my support. Look at that, see? Look at that. He said, not my problem. Good luck. Jacardi's here to talk shit about y'all now. They're eating popcorn and enjoying the time. And they retired. Jacardi, you can come back if you want. I don't know if you heard everything I said earlier. Satero says, Rory Chen, I would like to dine with you to dine with the Syndicate tonight. Oh. Is Rory gonna accept that offer? That'd be an interesting alliance. Like, they're still building people here, too. This is a great camera view. This is Thorn's camera crew, by the way. It could have been much better. Again, Jacardi. That's fine. I don't know, like I said, if you heard everything I said earlier or not. You did not? Okay. I said a lot of information, important stuff. If you go back and watch it, that'd be great, because I don't think I could repeat it verbatim. But to summarize, a lot of things that I said, just don't be an asshole in our stuff. People out there are going to share different perspectives than I do. And just don't share with me. If it's something that I'm very passionate about, oppositely, because we can debate wrestling matches. There are other things that I don't think that are up for debate, and that's just my personal take. So if you learn anything from me and things that I'm passionate about, it's not in our stuff or even to me, debate religion, politics, that kind of stuff. I don't want to have a skewed view of someone based on that, and it's just better to leave that be. Because we're here for this and not that shit. So, and just don't troll me. There were some that trolled me. That'll get you a ban. If you want to play that petty shit, hit the ban button. The week count for general manager. Thorn spent all his credit. So here's the thing, Chris. That 2 out of 3 falls match, you got X Factor Evan in the corner there, not Chris. Is that character ready to compete yet? Because we can't make our match happen. I just wanted to point that out for you. Pinfall attempt here, NAW Championship match. I've been very distracted by all the results and the chaos that's been general manager election night. It's been one absolutely wild evening, in all honesty. But there it is, 100 bit donation, hip hip. Hooray, thank you for that, Chris. Putting you back into position. Do we have a statement, though, from general manager re-elect Thorn? Because this time he has a cabinet now with the syndicate involved. He said Al Gore. This guy. I don't think half this roster even knows who Al Gore is. I think that's before a lot of their time. He said, sign it. Well, just like Liam, I guess I'm going to leave people in suspense, huh? Garmr does. How do you know? The roster is doomed. Again, Liam, it doesn't have to be, though. Shake my hand next week. Pinfall attempt. And Rory Chen with the breakup here. Women's championship on the line. I mean, it's fitting, Garmr, that history is your favorite. It's fair. In the 1900s or something? I mean, why do you make it sound like it's ancient history? I don't like that sentence at all. It's not that long ago. Isn't it? Jesus Christ. German release suplex there from the Vixen of Violence, Velvet, the defending champion. If you guys like the 90s, we did a 10-episode podcast on the 90s. It's on our YouTube channel if anybody wants to watch that. We covered a lot of really cool stuff. I really would love to have you guys watch this series. It's called All the Good Culture. It's quite clever. Because if you look at All the Good Culture, ATGC, does anyone know what that is? Pinfall attempt here, Lana for the championship. Lana just pinned Rory. Lana is once again your women's champion.
Here is your winner and new women's world champion.
Super stereo.
Lady Andrea.
history being made tonight. A 17-time women's champion. That is absolutely wild. But yeah, if you guys check out all the good culture, ATGC, on the channel DNA, is anybody picking up what I'm putting down? When will you have your answer, Christian? Well, I guess whenever Liam gives me mine. It seems people are shocked here by the outcomes of general manager election night. The evil villain as it is, Thorn continues their reign of terror here over things. And Garmr, that's an interesting stat there too. He said, I'm going to be waiting a minute. That's fine, Liam. It's worth the wait. The end of this month is War Games. I'd hate to go in it alone, but if I have to, I will. I will be the one, just like last year, to fight off and finish a dominant faction. And one more important than ever to maintain the integrity and future. And hey, maybe it is possible for Grav to become a good guy to you all and show you that he can prove himself to be a good guy again. Is that possible, Liam? Do you think that's possible? Chad, do you think that's possible? Could I win your hearts over again? Maybe. He said absolutely not. On a personal note, though, again, I want to thank everybody for continuing to support what we do here. This is a special place. I want to keep that a special place. Let's have fun here. Let's focus on the task at hand. We have the best show out there. There's no competition to what we do. And that's a fact. You could debate ViewBots and all the other shit. That's meaningless, pointless stuff when you can't even go find an episode of other places' stuff on demand like you do. There's no history like we have. There's no archives like we have. There's no title history and documented data like we have. It just, none of that is like what we have. It's simple. We offer the best. And there it is, the lovely Lana. So. But on a personal note, let's keep this fun. Let's maintain the integrity of what we do. I will work at things too. I know I've had some feedback on some things. We're all human. Let's be good to others, make the right choices, and be the best we can be, and lift each other up when we're down. Because shit out there is not always the easiest for every single person, and not all of us often get to see different perspectives and the struggles and things that we all go through in life. And we all bring various things to this place, and it's often why we escape the reality to come here, to just be ourselves and find comfort and refuge in a place that we know and hopefully won't be judged. Let's all work on that together. Let's all make this place the best it can be. I want to thank you again. This has been episode 954 of NAW. We can't do this without you. I'm looking at you right now. We can't do this show without you. And when you stop showing up, that's one step in the direction of it having to end. Let's not do that. We will see you on the next one. As always, check out the upcoming cards. Watch, earn, redeem, repeat. I emphasize, come here to the channel. Redeem, 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 redeem. Stack that shit up so high so we keep having to do more and more and more and more. Because that's what we do best. Till next time. Oh, by the way, Thorn, you suck, man.